morning, everyone. Good morning. We've never had such excitement at the beginning of Mass, isn't it? Everybody was swaying. It's a beautiful time to be the body of Christ, as the entrance song have sang. The lyrics of it really invites us all to become the body of Christ, coming together as one, as a community, as a church. We have wonderful celebrations today. Today is the corporate Mass of CCW. We also have our Mass intentions today, which is for the eternal repose of Roland Sheely. And today too, I would like to offer this Mass too for my parents, Francisco and Consoladora. And today I would like to share with you the happiness that I have for the gift that I have received for the past 24 years, the gift of vocation to the priesthood. As a community, thanking God for the many things that we have received, we begin with the celebration of the Mass in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us now acknowledge our faults and failures as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you, son of man, I have appointed watchmen for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, O wicked one, you shall surely die, and you do not speak out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, are summed up in this saying, namely, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Amen, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my Heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there I am in their midst with them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters. Truly, today is a wonderful occasion as I celebrate my 24th. That the gift of the priesthood is not only for the person receiving it. The gift of the priesthood is a gift to the community. It's a gift for the church. It's the gift to the parish. It's a gift to everyone. It's not meant to be kept, but rather to be shared. I was thinking about how I ended up at this point, 24 years later. At breakfast today, I was telling one of the group there, I was just gunning for fifth. I don't know what happened. I overshoot. I went to the 24th. I was even practicing how to pronounce my name. When I was in the seminary, I was trying to check whether it rhymes or it fits. Father Kenny Aquino. That doesn't sound good. It doesn't sound good. I was trying to convince myself, does that really ring? Does that really good? Father Kenny Aquino. No, no, it doesn't. The love story started in 78, but then I knew nothing. And I was one of the least likely, if there's any yearbook, the least likely to succeed, the least likely even to finish. They almost signed up my release papers after 79. Just being there for 1 year, they can't wait to get rid of me. But I keep hanging on by fingernails, year after year after year. I'm always on the last warning list. Just one more angel to sign, and you're off. There's always a lot of tensions around, a lot of drama. So I call it a love story, or a love story always has a drama in between. Then, out of the 27 who graduated in high school, I was one who was gifted to be chosen to become one of the four out of the 27 to be ordained. But still, a lot of people, including myself, believe 24 years after, I'm still pinching myself whether it's true. But then when you look at it is in our own nothingness that God sees and looks at us and sees differently than what we know about ourselves. God sees more than we do. Maybe he has seen something, and I hope he's right. But he's always right all along. You can never escape God's invitation. He will always run after you. In my years as a priest, for the past 24 years, I always have that special feeling for Mass. I always have that affinity and affection for Mass. Mass is the most central of all. I like every word that I say that I would mean it. Not rush it. It's a prayer. For me, that is what stands out. Among all the things that I do, it's always the Mass. For it's then that I participate. I'm used as an instrument for all. Could you imagine if there's no Mass? There's no more church. Remove the Mass, you destroy the church. That is the central sacrament. For me, being honored, being given the privilege to celebrate it is by itself the greatest gift. The second, it is the sacrament of reconciliation. I know I would be lying if I say it's a hard job. Yeah, it is. We always look up to St. John Genet, who could sit at a confession for more than 3 hours, just subsisting on bread and water, hearing confessions almost every day for the past 8 hours. I can't believe where he gets his energy. Can you imagine people dumping on you all their dirt? Not only their dirt, but their spouse's dirt too. So it is. Everything else, they throw on you and expecting a solution from you. Everyone's trying to get something. And when you're in the confession, you are there as a judge, as a healer, as a friend, as a listener. It's a tough one. You don't have time to get the book or search the internet to find the answers. You're on the spot. You have to say the right words, or you will break the soul of someone. And your batting average should be perfect. No room for mistakes. No room for mistakes. But you know the beauty of it that was granted to us priests? It's the beauty and the opportunity of touching the soul of someone and making that soul whole again. Not out of our own power, not because of us, but in the name of Christ, we are given this wonderful task of reaching out to that soul and healing that soul again, making them feel the love of Christ truly. That's what the gospel and all the readings for today are all about. In the periphery of it, you know, we can see that it stands out is the call for fraternal correction. But as St. Paul puts it in the letter to the Romans, what drives us all in the observance of the law, or in asking someone to observe the law, or in correcting anyone, or in healing someone, is no other than love. Love should motivate us to do it. Can you imagine if us, our community, we truly care and love each other? Really. Then each one would be comfortable to think that someone is looking after their welfare. Therefore, one need not be afraid anymore. Can you imagine that as a community that gathers together, like a family that truly cares, a family that truly serves each other and look after each other? That is the invitation. We as priests are mere instruments, and instruments that God uses for all, like you and me. We are all instruments of God. And He calls each one of us to respond positively to this invite. The invite to care. The invite to be involved. The invitation for us to reach out. Each and every one. So you see, being part of a church as a priest for the past 24 years, I've seen the church grow. I've seen people who move away from church. I've seen people who come to church. I've seen people who are rejuvenated by the church. Some are hurt by the church. But in all of these varied experiences of people who come to the church, what I saw in my own perspective as a person who stand here looking at you out there, is that the church can only be built by people who know how to reach out because they love. It is only that. If you're going to bring something in the church, well, aside from the envelopes that you brought today, aside from that, don't think about that at all. But if you're going to come to the church, bring with you a heart that loves. That loves everyone. And you see how our parishes grew through the years. We met new people. The coffee and sweet treats that we did is a simple coffee and sweet treats. Nothing much. You won't even spend more than $100 for one Sunday for a coffee and sweet treats. Even less than that. It's a simple coffee and sweet treats. But look, the many people that you have met every time you go there. The first Friday Mass, it's nothing. It's all the abundance of the generosity of the people who brought the potluck or contributed money to buy something for food to share. But you know, when they open their heart and reach out and sit with another and introduce themselves and start a new conversation, a church is built. Look at the carnival, the first year that we did a carnival. You know, I was so touched by that. I know we were kind of nervous about the cost, that we might lose money there, money that is in the parish. But then at the end of it, we didn't lose money, we almost just broke even. But I was deeply touched by one family who was with us there when we were grilling the barbecue. And I recognized that she was and her family is from Lebanon. And then I said, do you know we have other, you know, parishioners who are from Lebanon too? And I introduced them, and they can't believe they've been here in the parish for many years and they did that, you know, kind of meet. And all the other friends that you built through the years, that's what parish is for. Introduce yourself. Don't be afraid to reach out to others. Build friendship. Never burn bridges. Build friendship in the parish, in your church. That's what we are called for. If there's anything that the gospel of today in the readings is emphasizing, care. Care for each one out of love. We thank the Lord in this Mass for this great blessing that we priests have received. But we thank you for continually praying for our vocation. We thank you for continually praying for all priests, for all those serving the church. Please continue to do that. And also pray for more vocations in the priesthood. We need some replacements as we would retire one day, so we can retire too. But more importantly, it is the Lord of the harvest who shares the harvesters and calls the harvesters to work in his vineyard. Let us ask the Lord to give us more blessing, give us more vocation, to give us more young men and women willing to serve in the vineyard of the Lord. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God, light from light, true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial to the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will never end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord. And reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
We give prayers to this man, so Sandra Rivera and Brittany Liriano. Thank you.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an ending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which should be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may grace glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
True him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
By divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of the Lord's peace.
grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endowed with life to the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that you may merit eternal share in this life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Let me ask the members of the Council of Catholic Women to stand and pray the prayer to Our Lady of Good Counsel. God of heavenly wisdom, you have given us Mary, Mother of Jesus, to be our guide and counselor. Grant Mary always seek her motherly care in this life, and so enjoy her blessed presence in the life to come. O Mother of Good Counsel, patroness of the National Council of Catholic Women, intercede for us that we may be wise, courageous, and loving leaders of the Church. Help us, dear Mother, to know the mind of Jesus, your Son. May the Holy Spirit fill us with reverence for God's creation and compassion for all God's children. May our labors of love on earth enhance the reign of God, and may God's gift of faith and living hope prepare us for the fullness of life of the world to come. Amen. Thank you. Just a quick reminder, announcement. We are starting today our RCIA program, which is the Rite for Christian Initiation of Adults. It is a program that is designed for non-Catholics or those belonging to different faith who wish to become Catholics, or for those adults who would want to take their First Communion or never had the First Communion before. So this is a good program for you. If you are interested, or if you know someone who is interested, we will have the initial session this afternoon at 1:30 at the parish office. Contact Dolly Brophy, she's the one in charge of this program. And also, I know some of you already received some calls from our volunteer parishioners. And these are the calls that they do for, in order to verify your data that are recorded in our parish registry. So they call on behalf of the parish. So please be kind to them. Don't slam the phone on them. They are not telemarketers. They are volunteer parishioners. And if ever you have changed your phone number and have not informed us about it, can you call the office? Our office angels would be willing to take down your new number and present it to Kathy Johnson, who would be updating our parish registry list. So we have about 1,714 parishioners, and so far we're still verifying a few hundreds of them. So please be kind to them. There's a simple reception after this at the social hall, and you're all welcome to join and celebrate the gift of vocation and the gift of God to all priests, especially our priest brother who's already present. May I now request our communion ministers to the sick to come forward. My dear brother and sister, you are sent from this assembly to bring the word of God and the bread of life to the sick and homebound. Assure the prayers and support of this community and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Please extend your right hands. Father God, we give you thanks for the vocation of the priesthood, which you have bestowed upon your servant, Father Kenny Aquino, and ask that on this day of his anniversary, that you may bless him with health, with your grace, with your peace, and that as he continues to serve you and to serve others in the holy priesthood, that you will continue to always be with him, strengthening him, giving blessing as he gives blessing to others, and that you may reward him one day for his faithful exercise of his priestly service. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.